talked about, in 2017, we had 761 overdose deaths from alcohol-related or drug-related deaths, but 692 that were directly related to this opioid crisis. And fentanyl, it's killing people, and it's killing people in numbers that double the homicide rates. And so, essentially, what I did is, as you stated, is to sign on with 63 other criminal justice professionals to say that this is overdose prevention. We need to save lives.
That is Baltimore City State's Attorney Marilyn Mosby on the C4 show today. C4 joins me, Robert Lang. We're talking about, this is something that hasn't gotten as much attention as her testimony in Washington
right. Today,
this week, calling for the legalization of recreational marijuana. But she has signed on, joining about 60 others, to a brief in federal court in Philadelphia mm-hmm. that would allow for a safe injection site.
The first one in America.
The first one in America. Philadelphia is trying to get this. This has been proposed a number of times over the years, mostly by now former delegate Dan Morheim, Dr. Dan Morheim. Mm-hmm. The idea is that those who are addicted to heroin or opioids have a safe place to use their drugs.
Correct.
And ultimately enter treatment.
Now, the thing, Robert, with this, we need to understand, as State Attorney Mosby said, is when you have overdoses to the extent that we have in Baltimore or in Philadelphia, what the attempt to do is to have people, we know they're using drugs, but to have them in a situation where they can at least be monitored and they don't kill themselves. And that's what Dr. Dan, he went to Canada. They're doing this in Australia. They're doing this in Europe. So while yes, it is facilitating drug use, Robert, it's also doing it in a way that's safe for the user.
And it also, it's the safety, and also it ultimately gets them off drugs.
The idea
here is that they would enter treatment. The Mike Gimbel was mm-hmm. quoted as saying that, and Mike, an addict, former Baltimore
Correct.
County Drug Treatment Center treatment director, said, among other things, addicts won't go to places like this because they think they're going to be monitored by police.
Well, that's not true. In Europe and in other places, they have gone to places like this. But here's the thing. Where I think he is right, he's also mentioned this, is you really aren't, you say, getting people into treatment.
Sure.
But the treatment component, it's not as much of a stick as it needs to be to get people into treatment. You have the carrot, which draws them in, but you don't have anything in place to force them in. They can leave just as easily as they got there. So I guess what I would say is I compare this to the needle exchange program back in the 90s,
sure.
where we actually saw the rise of HIV, and clean needles actually drove down all the HIV mm-hmm. numbers. But at the same time, you didn't really change the behavior as much as you drove down the disease.
And it is hard to believe, but the number of opioid death fatalities doubles the number of murders
amazing,
in Baltimore City.
And we don't
City.
Talk about it. We really don't talk about it. Now, we have seen in the last year a slight decrease in overdoses statewide. But if you look at the numbers, Robert, of what's going on all over the country with fentanyl mixing in with heroin and the rest of that, we have a crisis of immense proportions.
The C4 Show is back Monday, 9 to 1 on WBAL, News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.